Good evening, everyone. Tonight, a murderer's voice on 911 calls.
But is it accused serial killer Terry Blair or someone else? KMBC 9's Peggy Bright is live tonight with our top story. Peggy?
Well, Kelly, it may all come down to who made those calls for Judge John O'Malley. He is trying this case without a jury. Today, for the very first time, we're hearing tapes of those 911 calls in court.
This is 911. Can I help you?
The killer placed two calls on September 3rd and 4th, 2004.
What's going on?
I want to report a dead body.
Where?
On 29th and Park.
29th and Park?
In the backyard at the northeast house on the corner.
Northeast house on the corner?
Yeah.
How do you know it's a dead body there?
I put it there.
The prosecution contends that's the voice of 46-year-old Terry Blair, but Blair denied it in a police interview just after his arrest, and he got a boost for that claim today from a Wisconsin linguistics expert who testified for the defense. Dr. Thomas Purnell compared calls Blair made from jail to the 911 calls.
My opinion is that it's unlikely that these two speakers, the known speaker and the unknown speakers, I'll refer to them, are the same person.
Blair is charged with murdering six women who lived along the Prospect Corridor. Several of the bodies were found because of the killer. In the second 911 call, the killer said there were even more.
There's six more.
There's six more bodies?
Yes.
And you're going to call those in tomorrow, you said?
I'm going to call those in tomorrow.
But the killer made no more calls. Now the trial resumes next week when we'll be hearing more on the technology that was available back in 2004 for tracing those 911 calls. We're live at the Jackson County Courthouse. Back to you, Kelly.
Peggy, did the killer ever give a reason for the murders?
He did, in fact, give a reason. He talked about the fact that they were prostitutes, that he thought that that was disgusting, and he called them scum. And you'll be hearing some of that part of the tapes coming up on our news at 6.
Peggy Bright live. Thank you very much, Peggy.